Hey everyone, my name is Andrew Glanville, and in today's video, we're gonna be taking a look at a feature that I've been using quite a bit on all my projects here, and that is the glow feature under Resolve. So the two ways that I use this all the time is one is for highlight recovery, and the second way that I use it a lot is for adding an overall glow image to your footage. This kind of looks a little bit like the CineBloom effect. It adds a halation, a little bit of a glow around specular highlights or blown out highlights. And this is why I like it a lot, because before I had the CineBloom filter, I was trying to emulate a little bit more of that film look. Film transitions from blown out highlights to detail a lot smoother than digital does. If you see digital image, it'll go from pure white to detail and without a gradient between them. And that's what glow is gonna help you to do for a lot of different things. The first we're gonna look at is how to recover your highlights. In my first example here, as you can see here, this is my after, this is my before. I just did a quick grade on this node here. Let's just delete this one and show you guys from the beginning. We're gonna add a node before your grade. You wanna make sure that whenever you're using this glow effect to recover your highlights, make sure it happens before any other grade that you do. So we're gonna hit Shift S, and that's gonna add a node before. We're gonna call this one highlight. And then you're gonna go to Open Effects. Once you go there, you're gonna look and search for glow. Going to be right there, and you're just going to drag it and drop it. It's going to do this weird thing here that it always does. Just go ahead and go to composite, and let's fix it by going to screen. Now when I'm working with skies, I like using screen, so I'll select screen, and then I crank up opacity all the way up. This helps exaggerate what the effects is happening, so you can see where your threshold's going to be. Then we're going to play with a threshold by bringing it down all the way up, and you see right there, we're going to play right between your whites and detail. We want to have a roll off from white to detail as smooth as we can, almost as a big gradient from white to detail. I see that right there and I like it. You can see here in my waveform that rather than having a hard cut from detail to straight white, we're having this really nice round roll off. The next thing we're going to do is our spread. I'm going to play with our spread. Now the spread is going to, well, spread that blooming effect from this look, which we want to stay away from as much as we can. Go ahead and do something right in between, which would be right about, maybe right about there. Then take your opacity down all the way, and we're just gonna put it up just ever so slightly until I see the effect almost blending the two, the detail and the white, which is right about there, I think. Now, once you do that, you'll see that on the buildings, now we're getting this kind of blooming effect. If you like that, then leave it. I'm gonna remove it here just to show you how to do that. I'm gonna go to my luminance here under my qualifier, and I'm just gonna bring up my low. If you wanna see what you're affecting, hit Shift H. That's just gonna show you your selection here. We're gonna bring it until it takes over those buildings. We're gonna soften it up like that, and actually bring it back down a little bit so it doesn't get into the sky. Once you do that, hit Shift H again to deselect it, and now you can see your before and your after. As you can see here, it's night and day between those two here. I really like the look and how we were able to do that. The second way that I really like to use this is by adding an overall glow to your image. I'm gonna switch clips to this one over here. Now I did a quick grade here, and we're actually gonna add the glow rather than being before, we're actually gonna add it after. So I'm gonna click Alt S to add a node after. We're gonna call this glow, and we're just gonna drag our glow after. Now once you do that, again, we're gonna come here and change it this time to soft light. Now you'll see that it looks a lot better coming after, but it's a little heavy. So I'm gonna bring my threshold all the way down to right about there. As you can see, it adds some beautiful colors. I'm gonna bring my spread down a little bit, maybe right about there. And then my opacity, you can play around with that. We're gonna bring it all the way down and back up. So that's looking really nice. I'm also gonna play with my overall global blend, bring it all the way down, and just bring as much as I want. So now you can see that before and after. As you can see here, it adds a little bit of saturation, a little bit of contrast, and an overall blooming effect to the image as a whole. It works great when you have sun, when you have flares, when you have practical lights behind you, or you're trying to make a light look like it's blooming so that it doesn't go from pure white to detail, but it kind of blends from highlights to detail. Well, I hope this quick video showing you the glow feature and how I like to use it was a help to you. If you guys like these kind of color grading editing videos, make sure to subscribe. I'll be making more of these kind of things in the future. I'll see you guys in the next video.